Listen, I'm going to keep this message very short and sweet for the fans of RWC, Ringwar Carolinas. The last time that you guys seen your boy, the man that is 100% too legit for you, the defiant one, the unrecognized number one guy, when I went one-on-one against Rip Cannon. Now you see, I can say this like the man that I am, the tough man that I am. I have taken some pretty tough loss in my day. But there's one loss that I just can't seem to shake off. There's one loss that I can't seem to get out of my mind, and that is when I stepped in the ring with Rip Cannon. Rip Cannon was dancing like a jackass. He treated me like an answer of a trivia question. Now, Rip, now I'm gonna make your life a living hell, son. Now I'm coming for your head. Now I'm definitely coming for your RWC Television Championship. And if you don't like that, too damn bad. Because if you're not legit, expect to get hit.
Money coming in a hurry. Niggas on the run, ain't like Norris. Sound like a kingpin, but Ryan Fumming got my first plug out of California. Yeah, yeah. Peso stack, yeah, yeah. Dior hat, yeah, yeah. I've got wag, yeah, yeah. Ain't had nothing to do with that.
All right, more Ring Wars Carolina Battlegrounds action. The lethal one, John Washington, tries to get his first victory here as he will be taking on Mickey Fulp. Definitely exuding confidence.
Oh yeah, this guy, he's a colorful character, but he's also an accomplished performer, Jonathan. He's a former AWC Next Generation champion, a former Crab Wrestling Genesis champion, a CPW heavyweight champion, and a CPW tag team champion.
Those are all good accomplishments. They also show he's very well traveled through the states of Maryland, Virginia, and North Carolina. He does have the potential to beat Mickey Fulp. But I think he wants to rematch. I know last time he was here, he challenged Rip Cannon for the television championship and lost. And he's trying to get Rip Cannon, but he's not going to, unless the man is not aware that he's facing Mickey Fulp.
And he's coming from King of Carolina, weighing in at 185 pounds. This is Mickey Fulp.
You know how I feel about guys that smile too much during a wrestling match. However, not taking away from him, this guy is an accomplished performer. And he is a former AIWF Mid-Atlantic Wrestling Grand Slam winner, Jonathan.
Yeah, we told a couple of his matches when we were down in AIWF Mid-Atlantic. I tell you, I was impressed by the Candy Bowl thing more than anything. Winning that big Battle Royal that evening after winning a match where his name was drawn randomly. John Washington singing his own praises. That's not going to help you win any matches here in Ring Wars Carolina, though. Mickey Fulp, he's ready to rock and roll there.
Well, Mickey Fulp in the ring. John Washington, though, very much, while the contest has not begun, kind of dictating the pace, Jonathan.
Yeah, just trying to maybe get in the head of Mickey Fulp here. This could be a potential strategy. And now asking, well, that's kind of arrogant to ask the referee to hold the ropes for you.
He doesn't want to chafe.
He got in the rope, ring ropes the first time with no problems. And slow stretch here.
John, I don't like your attitude here.
How?
He's just asking for an assist before he gets in the ring. The contest hasn't started yet. There's nothing wrong with it.
I still think it exudes of arrogance, though. Speaking of arrogance, we're seeing it on display here in space from John Washington.
Some think that you exude undeserved self-confidence.
There we go, Washington. And that's what I'm talking about. Dictate the pace. Take everyone's eyes off yourself. Mickey Fulp waiting over there wondering when this thing is going to start. John Washington knows.
And there's an elbow by Mickey Fulp to stop any offense by John Washington. Good closed hands by Mickey Fulp. And continuing to mix it up. And a sidewalk slam by Mickey Fulp. Going for the pin here early. One, two, no. Well, I'll tell you what. That attack by John Washington did him little to no good as Mickey Fulp got in control and the first pinfall, potential pinfall in the match this evening. Mickey Fulp with the head of steam. Sorry, Steve.
Perfectly okay. Mickey Fulp out and over. Actually, you know what? It's not okay. Stop talking over top of me. I don't appreciate it. Use those things called ears.
I do.
Washington, use this thing called eyes. Move.
No, he doesn't. Gets hit by that big drop kick from Mickey's things called feet. Go for the pin. One. Two, no.
Mickey Fulp real close on that one.
Yeah, the lethal one does not looking that lethal at all now. Mickey Fulp coming in with the full charge, but no one there. Wait a minute, Fulp stops. Oh no, gets caught though.
Well, Fulp, he ran in there instead of running to the corner. He ran up the ropes there, but Washington watching and waiting just sweeps him out of the way there, and that was about as brutal a crash as we've seen in a minute, John.
Yeah, we have. And Fulp, I'm worried that the left knee may be a little damaged there.
Reasonable concern.
Yeah, and John Washington claiming he still wants to be in that championship title hunt against Rip Cannon. Well, he's not going to get anywhere. He just said
he's the next champ.
That's kind of a bold prediction. That's something you would hear out of the mouth of David Barnum, Spectre.
Washington ducking him, torqued the arm, caught the knee. Bulldog on a man kneeling on the mat. Haven't seen that before.
Slinking over is Washington as he goes for that pin. Two, no count though. Stop. Just a simple two count that we've seen. And John Washington worried about what the fans are saying rather than concentrating on his opponent in that ring. That gives Mickey Mo.
Boy, you like to nitpick, don't you?
I'm just going for what I see out here.
You think a guy that nitpicks as much as you did would actually dress well?
I do. I got a three-piece suit on.
Did your mom tell you you look good?
Yeah, she did, actually.
She's a very nice lady, but sometimes the truth not reported.
Oh, what a shame. I apologize, ladies and gentlemen at home.
You should apologize to your mother. You make her look bad.
I do not. Speaking of looking bad, Mickey Fulp's looking pretty bad out there right now. Oh. Look at the headbutt. Great knife-edge chop. Can Mickey Fulp get on the offensive here? Oh, no way.
Well, he tried. He failed. Here comes Mr. Washington. Big time splash.
One, two. All right, Steve, you got to agree with me on this. Had he hooked the leg, Washington would be victorious right now. Potentially.
I mean, potentially, yes. However, let's not make light of what happened there. After that splash there, he had all of his weight down on those shoulders there. Maybe he didn't want to move out of the way. Maybe he thought with the impact, keep my weight on top of him. Don't flinch for a second.
And that's a fair analysis of the situation. But now just open palm and Mickey Fulp getting in the man's head. Not a good tactic as we see Fulp regain his strength and strike away.
And both these guys came to fight today. It seems like each man has an answer for the other one.
Yeah, Fulp there with some speed but gets caught.
Washington moving out of the way. Snapmares Mickey Fulp out of the corner.
Yeah, Washington measuring Fulp. Can he get it off with an elbow? Oh! God, right to the back of the head. That'll ring the bell hard.
Excellent falling elbow off the middle rope there. And Fulp, he's feeling all of this right now. And he's had quite a few blows to the head there.
Yeah, but Washington continuing his verbal tirade. Very unorthodox tactic. You figure you want to stay on Mickey Fulp if you want your first win here in Ring Wars, Carolina.
And you know, Washington's done a lot of damage out there. I think right now if you pick the body part, this might go his way.
Yeah, he hasn't so far because those clotheslines by Fulp keep him going. And speaking of body parts, Fulp...
It's like he feels nothing.
Yeah, monkey flip to John Washington.
And Washington flew halfway across the ring there. Fulp running in after him. Big corner splash there. Snapmares Washington now. Drop kick to the back of the head. And literally, these guys so evenly matched on their strategy this morning.
Yeah, and Mickey Fulp dropping that one strap as he... Oh! What?
Catches him. Leaping double knee smash to the face there. Might have knocked him out.
One, two,
he's got his foot on the rope.
Wow!
Foot is on the rope. Great awareness by Mr. Washington.
Yeah, I'll give credit where credit is due. That was good ring awareness to stop the pinfall count. Fulp calling for it.
Well, don't call for it, do it.
And Fulp now getting the momentum going, getting it shaken. He's got Washington up.
But Washington, though, gets behind him, nails the shot to the back of the head once again.
Well, he dropped that elbow just a couple moments ago. And Washington now throws down Mickey Fulp like yesterday's garbage.
Dumped him face first, that's it.
Well, John Washington is victorious.
So impressive today, really.
Yeah, I mean, he took it to one of the strongest competitors here in Ring Wars, Carolina.
Innovative, unorthodox offense. That's the name of the game. So many times I thought that guy was going to go one way, and he went the other. And it finally caught Mickey Fulp in the end.
Yeah, now it'll be interesting to see if he can get in that championship title hunt again against Rip Cannon for the RWC Television Championship.
You hear him, John? Tell Rip Cannon already.
I'll get to it after later on. Speaking of later on, we'll be back in just a moment.
Should do it right after the match, you lazy.
I need some motherfucking views.